Büyükşehir'de şu an bu iki kitap görünüyor sadece. Çağlayan kitap evinden.
Alttaki değil mi?
Yazarlar aynı, evet.
Tamam. Sonra
İçeriği
diyeceğim.
İçeriği aynıdır değil mi?
Tabii. Yes. Hiçbir fark yok. Son ver, ilk versiyonlarında Python yoktu. Sonradan Python eklediler. Assembly Simple Machine yine aynı duruyor. Ben de aynı. Fark tefek değişiklikler var. Chapter'ların yerlerinde numaralarında değişiklikler var.
Orada da ikisi de tükenmişti.
Getirmemişlerdir. İnsanlar almamaya başladı. So, let's continue. Today, I'm going to move on to developments in Europe, including the effect from Islamic world to European development and start of the Renaissance. At 11th century, most Europe was Christian, so around year 1000. Stronger monarchies were present. There were kings. Kings were very strong. There were borders. Technological developments, agricultural innovations were starting slightly. Food was increasing. Since food was increasing, population was also increasing. So food and population was increasing. Classical Greek texts were translated from Arabic and Greek into Latin. So from Arabic and Greek to Latin. Stimulating scientific discussion in Western Europe. So scientific discussion in Western Europe started from classical Greek texts, Greek, Egyptian and Sumerian texts. Into Latin language, also from Arabic. Arabic also contained influences of, again, Sumerians and Indians and Chinese. University, obviously not in today's common sense, but very early days, medieval universities were started. Medieval universities were religious universities. Religious and science, scientific work was going together. So heavily religious universities. But they started thinking. European contact with Byzantine Empire and Islamic world during Crusades allowed Latin Europe access to scientific Greek and Arabic texts. So in last week we said 1204 they invaded Istanbul. When they invaded Istanbul, a lot of Greek text and Arabic text and also people, there was a great deal of interaction in between European scholars and Greek scholars and Arabic scholars. European scholars had access to translation programs of Raymond of Toledo, who sponsored the 12th century Toledo School of Translators, which is very important, from Arabic to Latin. Where is Toledo? In Spain. It's a very old city, famous for its knives and swords, metal helmets and armories, all kind of metal work was done in Toledo. Also there was a university. Also there was a Raymond of Toledo School of Translators. They started translating Arabic from Arabic to Latin. This is the school. Toledo School, that is the Cathedral of Toledo, became a translation center in 12th century. So 12th century is just about the time when Anatolian Selçuklu Turks were spreading in Anatolia along with the Greek, along with the Byzantium. So a group of scholars who worked together in the city of Toledo during the 12th and 13th centuries to translate many of the philosophical and scientific work from classical Arabic. Large amount of books were translated. Among these, Ptolemy's Almagest, I am not familiar with all of them. El-Harizmi's on algebra, El-Mujabale, Archimedes on measurement of the circle, Euclid's elements, Jabir ibn Aflas Elementa Astronomica, El-Kindi's optics, El-Farabi, El-Razi, Tabit. So all of them we talked about last week. Ptolemy's Almagest, Aristos, El-Harizmi, Archimed, Euclid, El-Kindi, El-Farabi, El-Razi, Tabit, Avicenna, İbn Sina, İbn Vafit, El-Fargani, etc. Aristo'nun diğer kitapları, şunları, bunları. Önce Arapçaya çevrilmiş, oradan tekrar Latince. Because Latin language was a scientific language and university language, nobody cared about local languages, which was Spanish, Portuguese, French, Italian. The common language was, just like today's English, was Latin, scientific language. Later, translators like Scotus learned Arabic in order to study these texts directly. So some translators even gone further and they studied original text for the science. Furthermore, in those times, each king was putting himself into establishing a university for competing with the other kings. So each local king tried to have a university, just like the cultural center of the each city today, or the metro. Each city, when the city has a metro, it's a good city. So each municipality tries to make its own metro today. So in those years, having university was very good thing for the king. For reputation, they tried to make universities. So that is one of the reasons European universities were emerged in those years. Those universities studied nature as a main topic. Rather than technology, so they studied nature just like the Greek time. So far more greater emphasis on science than modern counterparts. That means temel bilimler, basic sciences, were the target. Because the need to explain, need to find, items related to Bible. So Bible says this, nature has this, so they are related. So come to our church. So that's for partly for religious propaganda. They studied science because they were high believers. In terms of medicine, it was interesting. In Greek and Roman times, studying on human was taboo and it was usually banned, except few scientists. In the Middle Ages, they started to work on human bodies. They started to cut human bodies, dead human bodies, probably. In 1275 and 1326, Mondino de Luzzi lived between those years, made the first anatomy textbook based on human dissection. So they cut human bodies, they learn what is inside, and they made an anatomy book explaining human body. There was a Mongol invasion of Europe. Mongol invasion of Europe destroyed a lot of things. But after that, Mongols and Europeans made an agreement. Under that agreement, people started moving east because there was an agreement. Marco Polo was during that time, after Mongol invasion and establishing the peace, named Pax Mongolica. I think Pax Mongolica is Latin word, or Pax means peace. Mongolica is Mongol people. So Pax Mongolica is Mongol peace treaty. They went to east, and awareness of presence of Indian and Chinese culture and civilizations were obtained. So they knew there was a China, there was China, there was India. Things came from there, and there were people, although limited number, there were people coming and going to East countries. Not only science and explanation of astronomy and human body, also technological things also happened. For example, Cistercian blast furnace to make steel, very good steel, is invented by bishops of a church of England. So along with the praying, they also made steel in the church. So because they had a lot of spare time, as I said before, other people were working, there were class differences, serfs, etc. So only religious people were very free to think about certain things and invent things because they have time. And they know how to read, write, etc. One of the guys, at the same time, around year 1010, he tried to fly over the top of the cathedral, I think. Yeah, it was the cathedral. Just like Hazarfen Ahmet Çelebi. He was also a church person. He broke both his legs and was lame ever after. He used to relate as a cause of his failure, he's forgetting to provide himself a tail, because he forgot to put the tail He was unable to steer it precisely, so he fell down. But again, it was not. He was known as a person trying to fly with the wings. It's before Hazarfen. About 13th century, which is 13th century means 12 something. The beginning of 13th century, beginning of Ottoman time, Orhan Bey, Orhan Bey, Osman Bey, those years, there were reasonably accurate Latin translation of the main works of almost all intellectual ancient authors. So libraries contained all translations, hand copies. And universities and monasteries were aware of these ideas. So there were a lot of books. So if you know how to read and write, if you have a lot of time in the church or monastery, then you can become a scientist in the church. So university and monastery are kind of related, and the boundary is not well defined in those years. The key names of those areas: Robert Gross Seste, Bacon, Magnus, and Scotus. Early people. Those years. Obviously, you don't have to memorize these names, but when you come up with these names, such as Roger Bacon, just remember it that way. 14th century is further fast. A lot of scientific important work was done on expansion of Aristotle's scientific writings. Principle of parsimony, natural philosophers should not postulate unnecessary entities, so that motion is not a distinct thing, but is only the moving object, and an intermediate sensible species is not needed to transmit an image of the object to the eye. So what is the object? How it is moving? What am I seeing? So they started thinking that reasoning things. Scholars such as Buridan, Oresme, started to reinterpret elements of Aristotle's mechanics. So translation of those books are also studied, and new additions and postulations were made. For example, Buridan developed the theory that impetus was the cause of the motion of projectiles, which was first step towards the most modern concept of inertia. So when you throw something, it follows a path. So how, depending on the angle, obviously they couldn't find the formula, but they studied it. If you hit it, if you send it up, it goes back. If you send it with an angle, it goes further, etc. Then there is a school named Oxford Calculators, located in Oxford University today, named Oxford Calculators. They studied mathematics, and they studied kinematics of motion without thinking the cause of the motion. So how the kinematics, where does it go, speed, and etc. Oxford Calculators is interesting group in the 14th century, associated with the Oxford Merton College. These people, usually men, took strikingly logical mathematical approach to philosophical problems. Philosophical problems means why problems. So why problems are studied by logic and mathematic reasoning. Advances these men were initially purely mathematical, but later became relevant to mechanics. For so they started with mathematics, then they moved to physics. They used Aristotelian logic and physics, so all books were always there. They studied and attempted to quantify every physical and observable characteristic of objects, such as heat, force, color, density, light. So they studied physics. Aristotle believed that only length and motion were able to be quantified, but they used additional parameters for objects and matters, such as density, temperature, power, etc. This is like 13 something something something. Okay, in Ottoman time, it goes like 1. Murat, those years, so early time of the Ottoman Empire. Then in 1348, Black Death, veba, was widely seen as a disease, and it is known, it is assumed that it came from the East. It came from the Ottomans. So diseases were thought to came from Ottomans because they were invading Europe. In those years, for example, European houses have no windows facing east because there were people and disease coming from the east. World population, European population, decreased significantly, and that was also seen in Ottoman time, in Anatolia as well. So that prevented scientific improvement for a while, for quite a certain amount of time. Science is stopped. But one outcome was, since there were so many people that labor force became scarce, so wages increased. Wages of the workers increased because there were no workers living, not many workers living. So after the Black Death, I think I have it later. After the Black Death, worker wage was an important factor, and the rights of the workers started to become issue. Before that, no one cared because there are a lot of people, they were slaves from Roman time. In Anatolia too, farmers were slaves, literally. So they had to do what king tells them to do until 1550s. In Ottoman time, it was until II Mahmud. Tımar sisteminin kalkması, tam olarak kalkması. Fall of Constantinople, Fall of Istanbul is an important corner point. Ne? Geçtim de geçecek, gelecek şimdi. Important corner point. With the fall of Constantinople, rediscovery of ancient text was stimulated by that, because many Byzantium scholars went to Italy. From Istanbul to Italy, they moved. At the same time, at the same year, Johann Gutenberg invented printing. So it is very unclear that whether the era change was marked by the fall of Constantinople or invention of printing. They happened at the same year, but that year is very important. So by printing technology, information propagation increased dramatically. I mean dramatically. So that printing revolution starting 1453, which came to Turkey about 250 years later, paved the way for the scientific revolution. So reason of the scientific revolution, so the corner point, not the reason, corner point of the scientific revolution is invention of the printing. Around 12th century ideas started to emerge around 12th century. And in Germany, Northern Renaissance corresponds to Germany. Scholars shifted from original Aristo natural philosophy ideas to new, more advanced ideas. So more detailed ideas were emerged in Germany and North Germany, Austria, today, in terms of today, Germany, Austria, and North Italy. In those years, there was no Germany. I mean, there was no country called Germany or Austria Empire. It was small kingdoms. Each kingdom had its own university, each city. So modern science in Europe was, after the Black Death, resumed in a period of great speed by one, Protestant Reformation, which is the key, which is very, very important, Protestant Reformation. Second, the response of Catholic Church to Protestant Reformation, that is also very important. In the old days, before that, Catholic Church was very different. Remember from the last time, there was no marriage, Catholic Church. After Protestant Reformation, they started to recognize marriage as a religious thing. Before that, marriage and making children was considered as a bad thing. So people do it in their hidden free time. That is, so it was a thing that shouldn't be done. Okay. That's why bishops don't get married even today. After the Catholic Counter-Reformation, they said only bishops will not marry, the rest can marry, and we will marry you in the church, etc. So, but you cannot divorce. So they still made rules. Then by the 1492, the America is discovered by Christoph Kolumb. Constantinople, fall of Constantinople was very important. And again, rediscovery of Aristo and restudying of Aristo Greek texts, because not only mathematics and natural sciences, but also philosophy was studied by Greek people. A lot of philosophical text was available. So in people in Europe studied things, philosophical texts in Europe, and they started questioning the existing system of politics and religion. Northern Renaissance Belgium, Netherlands, Luxembourg, Germany, part of the France, and English, and Polish, Germany at the center. So that occurred in the Europe north of the Alps, not south of the Alps. Southern Renaissance is Italy, Venice, etc. Northern Renaissance is Germany, and England, and Netherlands, Sweden, etc. So that is linked to Protestant Reformation. During that time, for example, Copernic was one of the scholars those times, Northern Renaissance. We have an agreement in universities in Krakow, in Poland. So if you go to Krakow for studying in with Erasmus, you will find that Copernic was studied there. Between 1491 and between 1491 and 95, University of Krakow, University of Bologna, Padua, University of Ferrara. So those are the years where those universities were in operation. And he studied the earth. Until that time, Church was saying that Earth was at the center, there were layers, and other planets orbit around, and Sun is also orbiting around the Earth. But Copernic said, no. Pope was interested in astronomy. So he wrote a book. However, nobody cared about him. Roman Inquisition, Great Roman, Holy Roman Empire, right? In 1616, Holy Roman Empire, they said, Sun is immobile at the center of the universe and Earth moves around it. They said it is foolish. No, they said no, and absurd in philosophy, and that it was wrong. Okay, and they rejected it. Fortunately, they didn't kill Copernic, and not much people read the same book, so they put aside. Okay, not like Galileo. Galileo published and many people knew about it, so it was a controversy. They said they were against Galileo, and they also put Galileo in prison, but they didn't put Copernic in prison. I think because the Pope was interested in astronomy, they said, you found that? Okay, let's leave it somewhere. It is ridiculous, but let's leave it. So that was the idea. But Copernic was the first, actually. Then, Southern Renaissance, Italy. That was more related to trade, because Italians have ships. They were making trade in the Mediterranean and the rest of the world. So Florence, Tuscany, Venice, those areas were centers of the scientific expansion. For example, Florence, the city of Florence was very well known for banking and trade. So banking, stock exchange, stocks, lending, etc. Money was invented in today's sense. Money and bonds were invented in Italy. That kind of Renaissance later spread to Venice. Venice was trade center. So when there is trade, a lot of different things come and go, a lot of different people come and go from different places. So knowledge accumulation was very fast. Appreciation and money was also more. In those years, painting, architecture, sculpture, because there were a lot of money because of trade, music, philosophy, science, a lot of things happened in Italy because they were getting rich. Galileo, for example. Actually, see, 1642, 1564, Copernic, around 50 years earlier, maybe more. 50 years. So thinking of today's time, Copernic was in Kenan Evren's time, or maybe not Kenan Evren, earlier, Fahri Koru Türk, 1970s, right? And today there is Galileo. So that time, that kind of time difference is present between Galileo and Copernic.
Isn't Kepler before Galileo?
I think yes. So,
why we don't talk about Kepler?
I think I have it somewhere. Galileo was known as engineer, astronomer, and a lot of different aptitudes. He was the father of modern physics, not only astronomy, physics. Father of scientific method, experiment, writing, hypothesis, etc. So those are very important. So he was known as father of modern science. Obviously, European view of it. But he was a very good guy, nevertheless. His father, so those are the times when universities were giving degrees. His father was pushing him to study medicine, just like most of you. So father sent him to a medical school. He studied medicine. Then he was interested in mathematics, but he was kept away from medicine because similarly, very similar to today, a medical person gets more income than mathematician in 1560. However, after accidentally attending a lecture on geometry, so think about it. There were places, there were people giving lectures on geometry. Other students were attending in those lectures. How long ago? 500 years ago. So after attending a lecture on geometry, he talked his reluctant father into letting him to study mathematics, bayrak kaldırmış artık, natural philosophy instead of medicine. So tıp fakültesinden ayrılmış. So Copernic said, sun is at the center, others are rotating, although not ellipse. The old geocentric model of Ptolemy and Bible was discarded. So in terms of that, Copernican heliocentrism, sun at the center, regarded as the launching of Modern Astronomy and Scientific Revolution. I have read somewhere that Copernic was also influenced by people from East. So there were texts that Copernic was used, probably in Arabic, probably going back to India before that. But no problem. Copernic was the guy who was written a lot of text, and those texts were preserved. From that reason, if you invent something, write it down and get the patent, because someone else will do it later and your name won't be mentioned later. Even if someone else did that, make it public so that people know that it is yours. In the older system, bunu şey söylediğinde anlamıyordum. Celal Şengör, Ptolemaya falan diyor.
Ptolemaya.
Buymuş meğer. So that was the rule about 1,400 years. For 1,400 years, this was the model on the right. So Earth was at the center. Sun was somewhere in the middle. Saturn was farther away. Mercury, Moon was closer. They knew Moon was closer than Sun, but all rotating around it. This is Roman guy, Ptolemy, dating about 150 CE after Christ. Okay. So throughout the Middle Ages, it was spoken of authoritative texts of astronomy. Although its order remained a little understood figure, frequently mistaken as the Ptolemaic rulers of Egypt. Ptolemy is a guy. Ptolemaic rulers are Egyptians, so names are sometimes confused, the book says. Galileo, because it was later and church was stronger in those years, probably Pope was dead. Next Pope was not interested in astronomy, right? So Galileo's writings on heliocentrism had been submitted to Roman Inquisition, Inquisition. It is like controlling everything. It's even above the king. Inquisition by Father Niccolo, Father Pope, Father means Bishop, Father Niccolo Lorini, who claimed that Galileo and his followers were attempting to reinterpret the Bible. Kafir. Okay. So, in those years, at the same, around 1600, number of 100,000 to 9 million executions was given, all of which was attributed to the Inquisition. So, Inquisition Mahkemesi dediğimiz olay, 100 bin ile 9 milyon arasında, daha tam olarak da bilinmiyor, öyle bir öldürmüşler ki insanları. Yani 100 bin ile 9 milyon arasında bunun ortası yok mu diyebilirsiniz. Çok saçma bir şey ama öyle yazıyor kitaplar. Bunun 90 bininin başka bir yerde yazıyordu. Cadı diye öldürüldü. Kadınların, 90 bin kadının cadı diye öldürüldü. Söyleniyor. So Roman Inquisition, formerly Supreme Sect Congregation of the Roman and Universal Inquisition, was a system of tribunals, courts, universal, developed by Holy See of the Roman Catholic Church. Church established courts. Okay, religious courts. during the second half of the 16th century, responsible for prosecuting individuals accused of wide array of crimes relating to religious doctrine or alternative religious doctrine or alternative religious beliefs. Because people started to escape from those religions, doctrines of the Catholic Church, anybody who is trying to say something was punished, because it was against the ongoing church. This was the interesting painting later done in 18 something, early 18s, showing Galileo and Inquisition court. And it is interesting that, it is very interesting that to me, and also it is to other people, this is the judge, but there is a bishop staying there. So this guy is controlling him, but not saying anything. So they are trying to force him sign that Earth is not rotating around the sun, etc. There are other paintings, but I like this one. That's also famous. 1857 painting on Galileo facing Roman Inquisition. Probably, this is Christ. The layout was similar. And one important thing, maybe interesting thing, is European houses did not have carpets, because they did not have carpets. They never take shoes off, even today, that part, because it was too expensive. When they go east, they saw carpets, and when they brought carpets in back to Europe, they put them on walls because it was so valuable. They didn't want to put their feet on it. So in the Europe, in the early days, carpets were on the wall rather than on the ground. He later published a mathematical book named as Dimostrazioni Mathematics, etc. Interestingly, this is printed book, of course, printing was available. For example, the writer was Galileo, so his book, original book. These are drawings from the book. How this kind of information is spread? Again, printed book and universities and printed book spread the information through France, Germany, England, and Benelux countries, Belgium, Netherlands, Luxembourg, and all those small countries next to Germany and France. And Scandinavia. Writers and philosophers such as Rabelais, Pierre de Ronsard, Erasmus, Desiderius, Erasmus were greatly influenced by Italian Renaissance model and were part of the same intellectual movement. Erasmus is this guy, Erasmus. Okay. During English Renaissance, which overlapped with the Elizabeth era, English Renaissance, writers such as Shakespeare, Marlowe, created writings with lasting influence, with very long influence. They were all thinkers. Renaissance was brought to Poland directly from Italy to Poland, by artists from Florence and Low Countries. Low Countries means the smaller countries there. Starting the Polish Renaissance. So So Poland is also interesting place. For example, Krakow, if you go, Krakow is very similar to Vienna. So almost identical cities. When people study science, there are political consequences. So political consequences happened first by Luther and Calvin. They questioned religious doctrine imposed by the Church of Italy, Rome, because there was no there was no different sects, there was no different churches, only there was a Greek church, which was Orthodox. They probably didn't call themselves Orthodox, but they were said Greek church, and they were Roman church. And that was done by fall of Constantinople, I think. It's a little before, maybe. I'm not sure about that. When Greek church is separated, let's see. I don't want to give you wrong information. By 1054, Greek Church and Catholic Church were separated. That's why in 1204, they invaded Istanbul. Catholics invaded Istanbul as Orthodox Greek Church, so they were enemies. So, with the Luther and Calvin, they were against standard church practices. Furthermore, works of Ptolemy in astronomy and Galen in medicine, old Greek, were not found always to match everyday observations. Works by Vesalius on human bodies found problems with Galenic view of anatomy. So anatomy, astronomy, and other parts of science were trying to improve, but since the church was using previous views, the conflict was unavoidable, because you cannot change religious texts. Therefore, most historians says 1543 is beginning of scientific revolution in Europe. It is the time when books De Humani Corporis Fabrica, on the workings of human body, by Vesalius, and astronomer Copernicus, were first printed. Human body and astronomy. The thesis of Copernicus' books was that the Earth moved around the Sun. That followed by the book of Principia Mathematica of Newton. And that brought unimaginable growth in scientific publications throughout Europe. And also, there were in 1665, they started printing scientific journals. So publication acceptance, reviews, etc., counter publications became the norm among universities and science. Other names, some of them are, for example, some of them are mentioned, because there are too many people: Halley, Hooke, Huygens, Brahe, Kepler, Leibniz, Pascal. So all their last names are given to something, they, right? Those are contributing scientists in those years. In terms of thinking, Francis Bacon, Brown, Descartes, and Hobbes were main contributors of thinking and questioning. Scientific method improved after those people, and thinking about experimentation and reasoning became the norm.
Scientific method değil mi?
Onun devamı olarak söylüyor burada. Yani hepsi birbirinin şeyi, sonuçta father olarak belirliyorsun ama yani hiçbiri de tek başına father değil yani. Kredi veriyorsun sadece. This is, as I said, the opening page of the journal, first issue, volume 1, Royal Society's journal, not scientific, periodical journal. About the 17th century, 16-something, things are coming closer to modern science. And it speeded up in 18th century. So in 1700s, closer to French Revolution, as you come closer to French Revolution, Age of Enlightenment began. Critical innovation was creation of permanent scientific societies like the one on the right in the major Fransız akademisi, Alman bilmem nesi falan gibi, İngiliz kraliyet şeyi, scientific society gibi sosyetelerin olması, orada insanların birbirini tanıması falan. So it dramatically speeded the diffusion of the new ideas, the spread of the new ideas. One of them was Royal Society in London, 1660. Those times are very So at the end of 17th century, because 1780 means beginning of 18th century, right? So at the same time, so don't get confused with the Lale Devri, with spending and going out with the girls. It is more related to critical thinking and questioning and some scientific reforms, educational reforms, but unfortunately it couldn't move forward. So that was the same time, those same years. Progress of science with the work with Newton, Descartes, Pascal, Leibniz, the way was now clear to the development of modern mathematics, physics, and technology. Two, later, Benjamin Franklin, Euler, Lomonosov, Lambert, etc. And then there was an encyclopedia. That encyclopedia was very interesting at 1751, after Lale Devri, which Ottoman Sultan was in power in those years, 4. Mustafa or something after 3. 3. Selim. I don't know. So those years after Lale Devri time, before ikinci Mahmut. Okay? At the beginning of 19th century, ikinci Mahmut. Thank you for attending to the class and listening.
Biraz acıktım da düşündüm o yüzden.
Zaten dinlemedin hiç.
Dinliyorum hocam.
Öyle mi? Tamam. Laptopun açıktı çünkü. So, that encyclopedia was containing a lot of information together. Very big. And it was printed in multiple copies, too many copies, is an encyclopedia. I will come back to that. Using those encyclopedia, that encyclopedia was put in libraries, and people came to libraries and universities, studied the encyclopedia. So the time encyclopedia was probably widened with the Diderot's encyclopedia. And thinking and questioning those names, famous names, was Immanuel Kant, David Hume, Adam Smith, Voltaire, Jean-Jacques Rousseau, etc. It is a period where flowering of the European Renaissance in what is often known as scientific revolution together. So philosophical progress and scientific progress is connected to each other very tightly. I tried to give an idea. This image is very interesting, and it is very meaningful to me, maybe to you. People were coming together in the evenings. Of course, these are rich people. Looks like rich people. They were coming together, and they were reading a book together in reading sessions. And that in that picture,
they're English, right?
Huh?
They're English.
I don't know. Reading of the Voltaire's Tragedy of the Orphan of China. In the salon of Marie-Thérèse Rodet Goffin. You know French. That's France. Voltaire'in tragedisi. Tragedy of Orphan of China. Çinli yetimin tragedisi romanını okuyorlar. Ben okumadım. Siz okudunuz mu? Yani işte. Biz C++'a okay. This is interesting because one book is read by multiple people, so they are affected from each other. They do after talk, so a lot of thing goes on, and some rebellions against government in terms of thought. So a lot of people were killed and executed due to their political views. Scientists of the period, that period, widely circulated their ideas through meetings at scientific academies. Meetings. Masonic lodges, literary salons, coffee houses, printed books, journals, pamphlets popped over the Europe. One of them was in Istanbul, in Baba Ali. People were coming in. There were newspapers. Obviously old newspapers were coming into the coffee house, and people were reading those magazines, books, etc. And this at the same place. But again, since they started against common doctrine, it was closed one time after another. So it was closed most of the time. As people read books, the Enlightenment, aydınlanma, ideas of the Enlightenment undermined the authority of monarchy and church. And it gave the way for the political revolutions of the 18th century, French Revolution and etc. and later revolutions. Variety of 19th century movements, including liberalism, neoclassicism, traced their intellectual heritage back to Age of Enlightenment. Age of Enlightenment. When we say Age of Enlightenment, this is the Age of Enlightenment. And
zorunlu bir şey.
Hayır. Niye zorunlu olsun? Yani aydınlanmak için okuman lazım. Tartışman lazım. That was the time. Immanuel Kant, Hume, Adam Smith, Voltaire, Jean-Jacques Rousseau and others. So those are the famous. And what is the other guy?
Descartes
is earlier. Amerika'nın kurucusu kimdi ya?
Fikir babası.
Thomas Paine. Those are the guys who was famous for their philosophical work. The Enlightenment ideas are dangerous ideas for that time. They contained range of ideas such as sovereignty of reason, evidence of the senses, evidence of the senses, primary source of knowledge. So I have to see it, I have to test it. So testing and believing. And the other ideas such as liberty, progress, toleration, fraternity, friendship, constitution, rule, separation of church and state, and those are the things that were emerged after those enlightenment. In France, 10 central doctrines of the enlightenment, philosophers were individual liberty and religious tolerance in opposition to an absolute monarchy and fixed dogmas of the church. It's basically against church, because church was squeezing too much in Europe. Once they relieved themselves from the church, then other things such as limiting of the monarchy was available. This is Kant. Enlightenment was marked by emphasis on scientific method and reductionism, simplification, along with increased questioning of religious orthodoxy, of the Immanuel Kant's small text named What is Enlightenment? Answering the question, what is enlightenment? That is the text. I haven't read it, sorry. But I should. They're all available. And the date is 1784. He said, definition of lack of enlightenment. Hani yaparlar ya, bir şey nedir diye yapılan kitaplar, ne değildir diye açıklamaya başlarlar. Lack of enlightenment as people's inability to think for themselves due to not their lack of intellect but lack of courage. Kafan çalışmıyor değil de canın istemediği için aydınlanmıyorsun. Aydınlanmamayı tercih ediyorsun. Diyor, demiş. Kant's essay also addressed the cause of lack of enlightenment and the preconditions necessary to make it possible for people to enlighten themselves. He held it necessary that all church and state paternalism be abolished, doctrine be abolished, and people be given the freedom to use their own intellect. Sana hiçbir şeyin dayatılmasını kabul etmeyeceksin, kendi kafanı kullanarak doğruyu bulacaksın şeklinde bir şey söylüyor, hedef söylüyor. Kant, Immanuel Kant. Kant'ı geçtik. Let's move to Galvani. How many of you remember what galvanometer is? In physics, there is a galvanometer. Galvanometer is the meter that is predecessor of ampermeter and voltmeter. So it detects the presence of the electric. How much electric, how much current, galvanometer in both directions. So in 1780, Luigi Galvani in Italy and his wife, he has a statue there. Heykel yaptığın zaman böyle yapman gerekiyor. Bir anlamı olacak yani. Galvani and his wife discovered that the muscles of dead frogs twitched when they struck by an electrical spark. Kurbağa bacağına elektrik veriyorsun. Bacak hareket ediyor. So, this is from his work, the image from his work. So, they started to, the image on the right too, they started to find a certain size of frog to calibrate certain amount of electricity. So they started killing frogs and making electrical meters for using frog legs for scientific purposes. Therefore, later, Johann Oersted gave the galvanometer name to the device after him. So galvanometer name is given as we recognize him for detecting and measuring, making a device measuring the electricity with frog leg. Volta, you probably know this, invented the battery. He explains the principle of electric column to Napoleon in 1801. Napoleon is this guy. Volta is this guy. So in Europe, interestingly, kings, rulers were interested in science because it was also possible to use them in military. So he was explaining ideas of electricity in front of Napoleon. Volta pil diyoruz ya, because it is pile. It is column. One cell on top of other cell and top of other cell. So it is a column of chemical things. Therefore, it is called as voltaic pile. He invented voltaic pile in 1799, before II Mahmud. As the result of experiments, he reported the results to Royal Society in Britain, in England. With the invention, Volta proved that electricity could be generated chemically, and debunked the prevalent, disvalidated previous theory that electricity was generated only by living beings. Previously, people think that electricity was only generated by living beings because they couldn't solve the meaning of life yet. So electricity was the sign of life. So with the chemical reaction, he said we can generate electricity. It was a spark in great amount of scientific excitement and led others to conduct similar experiments, which eventually led to development of the field of electrochemistry, such as gold plating, and so on. Volta. This is Diderot. Diderot's Encyclopedia. It is published in France between 1751 and 1772. That is after Lale Devri. And this encyclopedia is very famous. It's too famous. Unfortunately, I haven't seen it. Maybe there is an online copy. But it is in French, so I don't speak French. I cannot read French. Maybe there is a translation as well. It is interesting. The numbers are very interesting. The name of the encyclopedia was not Diderot's encyclopedia. It was the encyclopedia, because it was the first encyclopedia. It was the encyclopedia. So that is the title. This was from the encyclopedia. The figure on the center represents truth, surrounded by bright light. Bright light is the central symbol of the enlightenment. İnsanların kendini kurtarması, toplumun kendini kurtarmasını sağlıyor. Bizim ansiklopedi gibi bir şeyi var yani. Adamın resmi var ilk başta. Two other figures on the right are reason and philosophy. They are tearing the veil from the truth. Truth'un üstündeki şeyi, örtüyü kaldırıyorlar. Reason ve philosophy adamları. Bizde çok gelişmediği için insanlar lafa kavramları göstermek, çünkü resim yasak. Bunlar işte her şeyi church modeliyle kafa öyle çalışıyor. Church onu çekiyor, bilmem ne yapıyor. Kavramları insansılaştırıyorlar yani. Bu şekilde resim yapıyor. İslam'da insan resmi yok ki. Yani şeyleri, kavramları işte, mesela iyilik meleği gelmiş, kötülük meleği şey yapmış, onu oraya, bunu buraya çizip de bunu anlatmaya kalkışmıyorsun yani. Öyle değil yani. Yani yanlış olduğundan söylemiyorum da, öyle bir adet yok. İşte şeyde yasaklandığı için. Monoteizme yönlenmek için çok resim koyarsak politeizm olur diye, resim yok demişler. Muhtemelen birileri. O yüzden resim yok. Yani resim ve heykel olmaması gerekiyor. The numbers are the encyclopedia. Volumes, 71,000 articles, 3,000 pictures, but drawn by hand, of course. No, there is no computer, right? First 17 volumes were published between 1751 and 1765. 11 volumes of plates were finished by 1772. Because it says engraver. These are plates. What is that? Kurşun hazırlanıyor ya, basıyorsunuz, o cilt, her sayfanın kurşun karşılığı var. Onları bir hazırlıyorsunuz, kurşuncular diziyor, matbaacılar. Çerçeve içine alıp sıkıştırıyorlar, artık o hazır, depoda duruyor. Basacak mısın? Getir kurşunları, tak tak tak tak tak tak basıyorlar. Engraver Robert Bernard, matbaacı, provided at least 1800 plates for the work. 1800 tanesini meşhur bir engraver şey yapmış. So it sold 4000 copies during first 20 years. 4000 copies of that many pages and articles. And earned a profit of 2 million livres for its investors. I don't know how much it means. Because of its occasional radical contents, as always, the encyclopedia caused much controversy in conservative circles, and an initiative on the Parliament of Paris, French government suspended the encyclopedia privilege in 1759. So, encyclopedia yasaklanmış. Interestingly enough, the encyclopedia had also been banned 1752 after publication of the second volume. Despite these issues, work continued in secret. Yer altında ansiklopedi basıyorlar. Artık hangi motivasyon? Partially because the project had highly placed supporters such as Wallace Herbs and Madame de Pompadour.
Yani destekçileri de var aslında bir taraftan. Authorities deliberately ignored the continued work. They thought their official ban was sufficient to appease the church and other enemies of the project. That's interesting. Government said we have banned it. Church says it has to be banned. And the government says we have banned it, so don't worry about it. Although they know it is propagating. So it was not an actual ban. So again, 4,000 copies, very large for that time. That time with the 18th century, mid 18th century, 4,000 copies of the same encyclopedia with 17 volumes, 18,000 pages. It was very large. Let's stop there at this point. If you have any questions, because this will take more time, I will follow this part later. Let me stop recording. Evdeki arkadaşlar, sorunuz var mı? Soru sorun ki biraz şey yapalım. Neşelenelim.